Hi, in this tutorial I'll show all the steps required to install the USC plugin for the S4 and S5 series headphones. Coming up. First, you need to check the headphone version that you have. If you have the S4 or the S5 version, only the S4X 1.3, the S4R 1.3 and the S5X 1.1 are the versions that do come with the USC calibration plugin included. If you have an older version, then you have to purchase it separately. Just write to our support and we'll prepare a link for you. It costs 49 euros. In case you're not sure what headphones you actually have, which version you actually have, you can find that on the calibration certificate or by going to our webpage. You can just click on the search icon over there, enter identifier, and you'll see the headphone version identifier webpage where you can visually compare your unit to all the versions available out there, but at the end you also have an input box, a field where you can enter the serial number of your headphones and you will be notified of the exact version of your unit. Once you know that your headphone version does come with the USC calibration or you purchased it separately, you need to register the unit on our webpage. In case you bought it somewhere else, like through Thomann, Amazon, Vintage King, other retailers. If you bought it directly from our webpage, then you can safely skip the registration step. In order to register your unit, you need to get to our webpage, scroll down to the bottom to the footer menu and find the product registration link over here. Enter your first name, last name and email. So this email is extremely important because it will be linked to your account later on. You know, select the model that you're registering for, a date of purchase, invoice and register the product. Now the next step is signing in. If you click on the menu, you can find the login button over here. And once you are at the login page, you have basically two options. The first one is to simply sign in if you already have an account or if you bought the unit directly from us, that is the way to go. Alternative, of course, you need to create the account. If you clicked on the create account, please use the same email as you did for registering your unit so that it will be linked. Alternatively, of course, you can sign in. Or if this doesn't work, of course, there's this forgot password section over here where you can resubmit your email and of course reset your password. Then the next step after login, you'll see all the purchase history if you bought things from us. If you did through Thomann or others, you will see nothing over here. And then click over here on the left top corner where it says enter the backstage. So once you're in the backstage, you can find the downloads and resources section where you have the USC 2 on the left, which is only for the X1. So if you will try to register through over here or download the USC second edition, it will not work for the S4 and S5 series. Over here on the right side, you have the USC 1 for the S4R, S4X and S5X headphones, as clearly stated, 1.1, 1.3 editions. Over here, you enter the serial number of your unit. Once you enter the serial number in this field, click Submit and the processing will begin. It will return two links. So the first link is XPS calibration file, so that's the actual data for your unit, and the other one is download link for the USC 1 plugin. Save them both. Once you've downloaded the package, you can simply unzip it and you'll find in there two folders, the Mac OS and Windows folder. Obviously I have a Mac, and I will install the audio units So if you just click on the package, of course you just go through the installation guides, and that's basically it. You install the software, there you go, and it's done. Once you do that, you can launch your DAW of choice, and most of them will automatically scan for you know, new software, new plugins. If that doesn't happen, you'll have to manually rescan for the plugins. All right, once you're here, you can find under effects all the audio folder, and you'll see the USC calibration. Drag it to the output of your choice. So ideally, you would have a monitoring output for the headphones separate, different than the one that goes to your monitoring speakers. In an ideal world, your audio interface would have the capability of sending different outputs to the speakers and to the headphones, and you would see both of those outputs inside your DAW, so that you could monitor, you know, with your headphones, with a calibration enabled, and a different calibration or no calibration on your speakers output. Once you start the USC calibration plugin, you'll see that the interface is very straightforward. Basically, you can make it smaller if you need to, or bigger. You have these options over here, but the main section is at the bottom, where you have multiple slots for multiple headphones. So in case you have more headphones than just one from us, you can have more of these XPS calibration files in there. So for example, I'll pick this one, import it, and now I have the serial number over here, and it is active. With the button on off, you can bypass it or turn it off, same as if you would use the internal control for bypassing a plugin inside the DAW. From here on, your headphones are calibrated with the XPS file. If you're interested in exactly the values, the calibration values for your unit, you can always open it with a text editor, and you'll see exactly all the bands that are being you know, corrected with the XPS file. There's also an alternative way of using the XPS file if you have DSP enabled audio interface like RME, Motu, Apollo, Neumann, through Mission Control. And those interfaces will have EQ directly on the interface itself, so you don't have to run anything inside your DAW. And you usually have the control of having the calibration or the EQ correction only on the headphone output. And that would be, of course, the recommended way. So we have a separate video just on that topic, on how to use the XPS file with third-party EQs. Go ahead, search for it in the library. Just on a final note, of course, if you're using a smaller interface like SSL2 or something like that, the monitoring for the headphones and the speakers will be linked. That means that when you're bouncing your mix on master, you need to turn off or bypass the plugin, as well as you need to bypass it if you are switching from headphones to studio monitors. That kind of concludes it. If you have any questions, let us know through support. Until the next time, stay safe and sound. Bye.